Banded together into magical guilds, they ply their skills in search of fame and fortune. Many such guilds dot the landscape of Fury. But there is a certain guild in a certain town that soars high above the rest. One from which countless legends have been born. A guild that will no doubt continue to create legends well into the future. Its name is Fairy Tale.
Just what I needed. Thanks a million, Lucy! Levy, Jet, Troy, Lucy, Gramps, all my friends, my guild, Fairy Tale. I don't know how many more people you need to hurt before you're satisfied, but it ends now! I'm gonna make you pay for what you did to my friends! Messing with Fairy Tale is the biggest mistake you've ever made!
I'm Lucy, a real-life wizard. And this beautiful city is Magnolia, a magnificent place full of magic and opportunities. Go right through the center of town, past the lovely Cardia Cathedral, and you'll find the home of the city's only magical guild, Fairy Tale. Oh, this cute little place is my house. A real steal at 70,000 jewel a month, trust me.
You told me your power comes from the things you've lost, your sacrifices. Having nothing to lose isn't the same as being strong. Fighting to protect what you hold dear, not giving it all away. That's true power. You can't live only for yourself, not caring about anything else. If you ask me, that's the very definition of cowardice.
You can't be happy. All you ever do is babble on about sin and how this world is a rotten place. But you made that choice. Just look at this guy. He may be lovesick and insane, but he's honest with himself. He chooses to live life to the fullest. If there's one thing Fairy Tales taught me, it's that no matter how hard things get, you never give up. We all laugh, yell, and even cry as hard as we can. We make the most out of every single day, because each one of them counts.
Even though everybody in the guild is allied to one another, some members that get along really well get together and form teams within the guild. That way, jobs that may be too hard for one person to take can get done by a team!
I don't like being interrupted! You hear me?
If you want to know the truth, apparently Scorpio went on a date with some other girl. Apparently someone even saw them! Taurus said he thought he heard Crux mumbling something about Nicola or somebody seeing him out somewhere. He said that he was slinking around with some cheap floozy in the human world.
If you think this is some kind of joke, you're dead wrong! You dare say one word to him about this, and I'm gonna make you wish you were never born!
The Council, ERA, is the most powerful organization in the magical world. It's only one step below the government. It has 10 members, and it's their job to uphold all magical rules and regulations. And if a wizard breaks magical law, they would be tried by the Council. Then there's the different Guildmaster Leagues, which are local groups who work together. Then the Individual Masters. It's their job to pass on the decrees of the Council. They also communicate with other Guildmasters on a regular basis. I guess you could say they're the glue that holds all of us together, which is a pretty stressful job.
It's only noon, and you boys are already whining like spoiled babies. I'm a real man! You want me to prove it to you?
Listen, pal. A real man doesn't tolerate that kind of disrespect. So get ready to get schooled.
All right, bring it on. Go nuts and hit me with everything you got. I'm gonna see you rip those puny little arms of yours to shreds.
Now listen up. Any power that surpasses reason still comes from reason, right? Magic isn't some kind of miraculous power. It is a talent that only works when the flow of energy inside of us and the flow of energy in the natural world are in perfect synchronization. To perform magic, one must have a strong mind and the ability to focus. It should take over your being and come pouring out of your soul. If all we do is worry about following rules, then our magic will never progress. Don't let those blowhards on the council scare you. Follow the path you believe in. Cause that's what makes the Fairy Tale Guild number one!
I'm not convinced we haven't been given clues. The old man may be a sadist with his tests, but in the four times I've been through this trial, there's never been a task that was impossible. You get me? I have a feeling he may have subtly given us all the clues we need to find this thing. Then again, I could be giving him way too much credit. What do you think? You're overanalyzing. Just say it like one of your Lucyisms. When you die, you become a shooting star! Something like that.
How come my dad hasn't come back yet? But sir, he told me that he'd be back in 3 days. And he's been gone for over a week now! Please, Dad, go to the board and take a job! I can't handle all this teasing anymore!
I'm so pathetic. I defeated 19 of those brutes. But the 20th, that's the one that got me. I'm so angry with myself, embarrassed to go home and face Romeo.
Our poor old master is working overtime in order to protect us from the real nightmare. Shame our new master couldn't handle it. Freed's enchantments should last for a few more hours, but they haven't even picked up her trail yet.
She says I'm staying in here and I'm not coming out.
Then why'd you tag along?
What kind of crazy job would force Makau to come to a place like this, she inquires. I want to go back to the guild, she proclaims.
Oh, wow, Miss Lucy. I almost forgot what a nice figure you have. Why don't you come give me a smooch?
Oh, yeah, and he's a big perv, too.
Don't touch my woman!
Your woman? Them's fighting words, you mookie!
What was that? You want to join Fairy Tale?
Salamander!
I've been looking all over for you. I wanted to personally invite you to the party I'm having on my yacht tonight. Just as I thought. I guessed you were a wizard the moment I laid eyes on you. No matter. The invitation still stands.
Well, first things first. Allow me to tell you about the job.
Go on.
It's pretty straightforward, really. Duke Everlew has a book called Daybreak in his possession. I would like you to burn it for me. Daybreak. It must be burned. It cannot be allowed to exist any longer.
Well, well, what do we have here?
So you thieves are looking to pilfer Daybreak from me, are you? Boy, oh, yo. I knew all you low-life wizard types were coming around here to take something of mine. I never would have guessed it was that stupid book.
Perhaps we should put him in his place. So you're a fire wizard.
Sorry to break it to you, kid, but fighting fire wizards is something we do well. Very well.
Can you believe that these little punks are from the Fairy Tale Guild? Talk about a bunch of runts.
Whoa, you sure talk big for such a little guy.
Fairy Tale may be a big-time guild and all, but you pathetic wizards are no match for trained mercenaries like us.
So you're a maid?
Yeah?
I assume you're here, because you saw the ad that the master placed in the paper. You heard the man. Get going, ugly.
You summoned, mistress? What can I do for you?
Who are you?
What's up, Burger? Man, you look great. You've lost some weight.
My name's Virgo. I apologize for any trouble I might have caused you. I'm a very loyal spirit who'll do anything to please her wizard. So I try to take on whatever form I think my wizard will find most appealing.
Well, I do know a thing or two about ancient texts. I'll start by taking a look at what was written on the flyer itself. This is what it says. May this eternal exchange provide you with eternal happiness. Kinda cute, isn't it? In other words, everybody who's been switched by this spell will live happily ever after. You're so lucky! I'm so glad I figured it out.
As far as the guides, it's a tough call, but I'd put my money on Loxus or Mystigan.
You're taking this too far! Calm down, man!
I didn't realize it till now. He's not fighting back.
The Shadow Gear team is here to save the day! You guys will be back to normal in no time!
I know Loxus is strong and all, but something's not right. It seems like Gajiel's going down too easily.
I see the town up ahead. A bit farther and I'll have revenge.
You're one of those pesky fairy tale flies. What are you doing here? So you were able to break through my wind barrier. You little flies can be such a nuisance. Now get out of my way, kid. Or else...
I'm
jealous, Maki. Your wizards are all full of life, and they're such cutie pies. I hear you've got a girl that gave some big shot quite the spanking. Oh, so naughty. Wow. Oh, Maki, you shouldn't talk about your little wizards that way. You're such a scoundrel.
I've grown tired of you cowardly wizards and your antics. I can no longer hold back. I shall come forth to devour you myself. I shall feast upon your pitiful souls.
Hey, Lucy. How would you like your hair done today? Baby, whatever you say, baby. Okay, I'm done. Does this look fabulous or what, baby?
A friend said something recently that made me think. She told me I deserve to be happy. Which shocked me, because I've never thought of myself as unhappy. She just doesn't understand. I have two adorable little students that I spend each day with and watch them grow into men. What more could I want?
The voices seem to come from down here. I hate being awake during the day. So, Toby, were you exposed to the moon drip? You've got those pointy ears.
I already told you! They're a fashion statement, you jerk!
Lighten up, I was just teasing you.
It's my sock! It just disappeared, man! It's been driving me crazy because I feel like it's right under my nose! But I can't seem to find it anywhere! I'm so ashamed! I've been keeping it to myself for months now!
Yuka, Toby, something terrible has happened. It's Angelica. She's been attacked and I'm sad. She's not a rat. She's a brave hunter prowling the jungle to protect us. She is love.
Nothing has changed. I was always the superior student, and I'm still stronger than you. I was able to master single-handed ice make magic, while you still have to rely on two hands. It's just like the old days. We may have chosen different paths, but we're frozen in time. Our rankings as wizards never change.
Oh, wow! I haven't seen you in forever, Lucy!
Hey, Lyra!
Say, how come you never call me anymore? It's not fair. I would love to help you out, but you ignore me, meanie.
Everyone on the island has suffered horrible disfigurement because of this curse. Not even the animals have been spared. We've consulted with dozens of doctors, young man, but they all agree that no such disease exists. You see, our symptoms began around the same time the moon fell under an evil spell.
The name is Bobo, and if you must know, I used to be a citizen of Galuna Island. But I had to flee. I just couldn't take it anymore. I should warn you, tragedy befalls anyone who steps foot on the island. There's no avoiding it. That is, unless you're able to lift the curse. This vile demon's curse.
I have the ability to control an object's time, meaning I can take the crystal back in time to before it was broken.
What kind of magic gives you that power?
I practice one of the lost magics called the Arc of Time. It's extremely rare and quite powerful. Would you like to see what happens when I throw this crystal ball into the future?
Wizards possess something like an internal container that determines how much magic power they can have. Though it's depleted with every spell you cast, your body naturally draws in ether nano from the surrounding atmosphere all on its own, and continues to do so until the container is full again. But recent research has revealed that there is a part of this container and the magic it holds that goes unused. A reservoir of dormant power. They've come to call these hidden troves of magic the Second Origin.
I could either spend the rest of my life in prison, or lose my life and be done with it. Whatever happened, at least my penance would have been paid. Dark guilds, and any evil force in the world that seeks to destroy the lives of innocents. We'll purge every one of them so no wizard will be possessed by his darkness again.